Hello guys and welcome back to the Southampton Career Mode here on FIFA 21. And today we are going to start off with a few announcements and a few new players around the club coming from a few various different locations. You'll see what I mean by that in a short second. I'm going to show you some guys we have signed in the transfer market. As you can see, no one currently here in the first team knocking about, but we have signed two new players, a new centre-back and a new left-back. They are Moussa Sissoko for centre midfield and Mladenovic at left-back. You might be thinking, Jake, you're in the Champions League this season. What are these signings? Have you absolutely lost the plot? 31-year-old Moussa Sissoko, who's now heading down in rating, and Mladenovic, who's a 70-rated left-back, who I've never heard of, but he's got 82 pace, and trust me, this guy has got a little bit of quality about him. I can't wait to see what he can actually do in game. And Mr. Soko is a kind of player I kind of need in this team, someone who's going to put the work in the midfield with the likes of Ward-Prowse and Puig being very creative players. Ward-Prowse definitely puts work in, but he can't move across the pitch as much as Mr. Soko can. And also, he's got a lot of experience in the Premier League and in Champions League football as well. He's not really in at the Tottenham picture at the moment. They've signed a couple more midfielders, and I thought, you know, why not? I brought him in. I think he cost me £15 million, probably more than I should have paid. But he came in. Mladenovic came in. He came in for £2 million. So we still got £40 million plus to spend. So don't worry. There's still money in the club. And still suggestions will be taken on board for future transfers, if you have any. For any position at this point, I feel set for this team. A new goalkeeper might be nice, maybe a world-class goalkeeper for £40 million. But we don't have to spend that money. We're not stretched to go and do that. I'm really pleased with how the team's actually looking. But I have some more new players. And they come in the way of youth players. And there is some very decent potential here for us to take a look at right now. And I'm going to sort this by overall just to show you guys the best player in the youth academy right now. And it's Diogo Silva, who is a 16-year-old centre-forward from Brazil with potential of 72 to 94. 5'10", right-footed with 3-star skill moves, 3-star weak foot. That comes with 77 dribbling and 71 pace. 74 acceleration, 78 agility. He's not sprint speed-wise, he's not that quick right now, but he's decent in small bursts, which is okay. He's got 83 ball control, which is brilliant, and 77 jumps. So this guy is going to be very technically very good on the ball. He may not be sprinting and counter-attacking on the pitch, but when he's got the ball, he's going to be difficult to get the ball off, and I do like the look of this guy. I'm not sure what position, actually, I'm going to want to play him at, whether to convert him to a striker and work on his finishing, because his finishing stats are pretty low right now. So maybe we could just try and bump that finishing stat up there as quick as possible and get him to be a striker, or whether I want him to be a cam, but we'll see what happens with him. We've also got this guy, Michael Pavlak. He is a cam right now and can play centre mid, 5'9" from Poland. He's gone up a rating already this season to 64. I'm training him as an attacking midfielder. He's doing all right. He's progressed pretty well. He's got 72 dribbling. His passing's okay. His pace is okay. Not really stand out in any area, but a very solid-looking player. And at 16, as well as Diogo Silva at 16, I think I'm going to promote these guys in a second and maybe send them out on loan for this season. Bang Chi is the Chinese winger. He's right-footed, 5'7", has okay potential. Not going to be like the world's best player, but 62 rated right now with 76 pace. That's coming with 84 acceleration, which I like to see. He could, you know, eventually become something decent, but he's in here for now. We've also got this guy, Luka Michel. He's a 6-foot centre-back from Belgium. He's currently 15, can also play right-back. He's got 5-star weak foot with high defensive work rates, 78 physical, 75 pace. This guy's an absolute beast, and he's only 15. I can't wait to get him through at centre-back. Another 15-year-old centre-back who's an absolute beast is Reece Brown. I mean, we've got some absolutely unbelievable players among our ranks now. And I'm going to promote a few of these guys. Even this guy down here, he's only 57 rated at 16, a striker from Turkey. Again, 5-star skill moves, 4-star weak foot. He's not the quickest, but maybe he shouldn't even be a striker. Maybe we should maybe look to move him, but I'm trying to train his stats to become more of a striker, get his finishing stat up and stuff like that. But I'm going to promote these guys right now, and then we'll jump into the first game of the season. All my 16-year-olds out of the youth academy, and 17-year-old Bobby Page, of course, as well. He can get promoted. He doesn't have the greatest look to him right now. Another Brazilian here. You know what? I'm just going to go ahead and promote these guys first. Just in case I run out of room in the first team, and then I hate to have the best players stuck in the youth academy. But we're going to get all the 16-year-olds in, and then our youth academy looks a little bit lighter, but a bit of quality in there left for sure to come through. Our squad's looking thicker with youth talent as well. But let's get into our second game of the season against Liverpool at home. They won their first game 2-0 against Everton, so they're coming into this one in a little bit of form. The place that we want to make a fortress this season. St Mary's Stadium welcomes Liverpool for their first game here this season. We couldn't probably have asked for a tougher one, to be fair. They've got an incredible team. A familiar face, of course, Sadio Mane, former Southampton man, now 29. Suarez will get us underway to Thiago Almeida. Out to Nuno Mendes. And a tough fixture against Liverpool in their spearmint kit. Almeida up against Cruz and can't get around him. Roberto Firmino. Gini Wijnaldum is going to put an early ball over the top for Mo Salah to chase, and he's going to clip it in, and it's dangerous. But Bednarak had watched it well. Salah's going to regain possession after Firmino's tackle. Firmino and Cruz, and it's 1-0 already. I mean, that's unreal. We haven't woke up. We haven't turned up yet. We started with the ball, and Liverpool just bullied us into getting it and score. It's Kyle Walker Peters up against Sadio Mane today. Ricky Puig's going to put that one out to Nuno Mendes, who's got the job of trying to keep Mo Salah quiet this afternoon in his second game for the club. Ward-Prowse is going to find Nuno Mendes coming forward here, actually. He is definitely more of an attacking player than defensive. And his cross is going to be cleared away. Sadio Mane will pick up the loose ball. Tackle from Firmino, but can't dispossess Almada. And eventually the ball will find its way back out for a throw-in. Mendes again to take. Ward-Prowse back to Nuno Mendes this time. Ward-Prowse's ball. And Ihattaren has got through here. And Bonucci with a block. Ihattaren keeps it in play. And it's Suarez. And he went for a fancy back heel. And it pops up into Alisson's hands. Nuno Mendes will find James Ward-Prowse. Now here's Almada. And Housen to find Ricky Puig. Liverpool feel it trying to press here. Suarez, his pass is a little bit loose. And gets away from Almeida there. Will press on Bonucci. And that's a terrible pass, and Suarez is going to smash home an equaliser. And what has happened with Liverpool there? That's absolutely Liverpool-esque in real life recently. But Luis Suarez has been given a gift on a plate while Liverpool just put across the box for him. Alisson, never again there. I'm not sure who he's actually trying to pick out with the ball across. I think it was Trent Alexander-Arnold whose pass went into Suarez. He says, thank you very much, and levels the game. Toni Kroos swings a ball in for Liverpool. Sadio Mane. Give it back to Toni Kroos. James Ward-Prowse snapping at his ankles. Roberto Firmino, edge of the box is Firmino. And back to Bobby Firmino, and saved. And Van Housden just edges away Bobby Firmino from tapping in. His own rebound, Mane's strike is blocked, and Nuno Mendes is going to find a way out into Almeida. We might just have got a little bit lucky there as the ball trying to get through past Virgil van Dijk is not going to happen, but persistent paid off for Suarez. Nuno Mendes, though, just giving that ball away very cheaply. Almeida, rainbow flick for Firmino. And then travels and slides it through, and Suarez has got the pace away from Virgil van Dijk. Surely for Luis Never mind. He had to flick inside to Puig, and he'll get it back from the Spanish midfielder. Crepin Diatta down this right-hand side. We've got so many men in the box here. Floats it across. It's not going to go towards Suarez. Puig back into Ward-Prowse, who volley was blocked. But right before the break, we might have a chance here. Ward-Prowse delivery. Suarez scored with his head in the opening day of the season. He's going to trouble, but it's going to be cleared. And at the break, it is 1-1. Man City, after a opening day defeat at the Emirates, are now at Stamford Bridge. And they are 1-0 up there. Fulham beating Newcastle by a goal to nil. And Manchester United are leading Derby by 2-1 at Old Trafford. There's Gini Wijnaldum for Liverpool into Bobby Firmino. Oh, that's a terrible tackle. I don't know what Bobby had said to him in the first half, but maybe a little bit of revenge there from Zeno. Sliding in and takes a booking. Gini Wijnaldum. Flipped forward by Keita towards Firmino. It's going to find Trent Alexander-Arnold. He cuts it back to Mo Salah, and he runs backwards. And then passes backwards to Bonucci, who's under pressure from Suarez. Eventually they work it back into a crossing position for Trent Alexander-Arnold, but Nuno Mendes defends well, but can't find a ball out. It is picked up by Gini Wijnaldum, and then we're back into Bobby Firmino. And they're going to eventually give it away to Nuno Mendes, who again can't quite find a Southampton shirt with his pass away. Salah still now persisting down this side. Now Trent Alexander-Arnold, will they eventually get the ball across? No, Nuno Mendes is just going to stick another tackle in. And this time we'll find Ihattaren. And now here's Almada. And Liverpool are getting broke on here. Bonucci surely can't keep with the pace of Thiago Almada. And he's not going to finish it. It's going to come back to him. And he's cleared it for Liverpool. Nuno Mendes keeps the move alive for us. Ward-Prowse, Almada. Genius. Ball back into the centre-back for no reason. Suarez can't get it across the pitch. Fabinho is back there. Liverpool might just about get away with that one. I'm not sure. If the genius ball back into the centre-back was the one there from Almeida, but it happened. There's Walker Peters and Liverpool all over the place here as Diatta skips past Virgil van Dijk and still crepping. Diatta is wonderful and he can't put it past Alisson. Salah for Liverpool. He'll find Firmino. Eventually worked into Bobby Firmino. Salah's run was continued, but Nuno Mendes is going to foul in a very good free kick position here for Liverpool. A couple of guys will fancy it. This man for sure, Virgil van Dijk, is going to want to smash this like David Luiz. Why is he putting the ball down? Who's in charge of Liverpool right now? Is it Ronald McDonald? Because Virgil van Dijk stole over a free kick with genuine intention in the 74th minute. Substitution for Liverpool. Nope. Coming off the pitch. Hold on. Scenes. Bonucci's being taken off for Gabriel Paulista. Maybe he's going to take the free kick. Another centre-back coming on. It's going to be Van Dijk over it. Van Dijk steps up and hits it. He's hit the bar. What is going on? Virgil van Dijk has picked up some sort of free kick masterclass over the summer and hits the bar. And Andy Robertson for Liverpool. He's going to find Mane. And I'm a little bit shell-shocked here that that's just happened. Bednarek gets there. Here's Ward-Prowse. We've got a breakaway here now. It's Almada picking it up. It looks for Mauro Jr. 10 minutes to go. Almeida's tired. Eddie Nketiah is on the bench, but I'm going to bring on Diogo Silva, our 16-year-old Brazilian, for 10 minutes of Premier League action. Before possibly taking a loan move out. I mean, if he impresses here, Diogo might be sticking around the club this season, but he's got to put a shift in, that's for sure, and do something pretty special. He's got the potential to do it. Let's hope he can fulfill that potential today. Here's Paulista for Liverpool. Firmino. Nami Keita into Bobby Firmino. Backed up into the air. Thiago's header. Under pressure, Alexander-Arnold beats Nuno Mendes to the ball. Chelsea are going for Liverpool. 5 minutes to go in this game. And Keita goes into Fabinho. He seems to be playing more of a centre-back role right now. Paulista, an absolute mess for Liverpool as Sissoko picks it up here. And he's going to put it over the top towards Diogo Silva. And surely no, Diogo. Oh, Fabinho, the fellow Brazilian, ruins his debut. Through one-on-one, facing another Brazilian in Alisson. And couldn't get the shot away. There's Ward-Prowse. Diogo again on the edge of the area. Can't get it away out of his feet this time. It's Bobby Firmino to Naby Keita. Nuno Mendes should be able to see this ball out of play. And does. Is this going to be another 1-1 draw for us here at the start of the season? It's James Ward-Prowse. There might be one more attack in it. It's Diogo Silva, who's done pretty well there to find Suarez, and he's going to get his way into the box. Suarez is going to carry the ball himself and going to win a corner last second. This is it, everything on it. Can we get 3 points against Liverpool? It's a corner. We have big men on the pitch. We just need a good delivery from James Ward-Prowse. Look how many men are in there. Just hit the heads, Ward-Prowse. And it comes towards Sissoko. It's in there and it's going to find a way out. An almost a dream debut for a couple of guys. Moussa Sissoko right at the death with the header. And Diogo Silva, almost a dream debut for him as he snuck through. But in the end, Liverpool hang on. And we take another 1-1 draw at the start of this season. Not sure what to make of this. It's a difficult one away at Crystal Palace to start off with. And then a home game against Liverpool. We've come away with 2 points. Hopefully the rest of the season is going to start putting a lot more points in our pocket. And as I've exited that game, the hero Suarez equalising for Southampton. But I've also got this email that says we've got a transfer offer for Suarez. I was expecting interest after last season. I don't believe that this offer is going to be anywhere near the amount that I value him at. And there's nothing to worry about. Who's it from and how much is it? Arsenal for 50. Wow, okay. That's not at all what I was expecting. Arsenal interest in purchase. Market value should be between 61 and 89 million. Arsenal offering a measly 50 for the record Premier League goal scorer for goals in one season. And that is where we end this episode. Luis Suarez, could he move away from the club for big money to Arsenal? Let me know your opinion of that in the comments down below. I don't think we can do it, but let me know what you think. That's going to do it for this episode. Thank you very much for watching. I appreciate it very much you made it to this point. And I'll catch you guys in the next one very soon.